Hi, I'm Dr. Ed Feinberg. Welcome to the online World Academy of Restorative Dentistry. This academy is unique, and we hope it will be a great resource for you, a free continuing education. The academy is devoted to the topics of crown and bridge work, full mouth rehabilitation, precision attachment partial dentures for both natural teeth and implant abutments, and solving the more difficult problems in full coverage restorative dentistry. Our mission is to educate dental professionals on proven concepts and techniques of full coverage restorative dentistry. These concepts have a 70-year track record and are not taught in any dental school. Some practitioners consider them to be old-fashioned or passé because they actually came first. When it comes to full coverage restorative dentistry, the profession went off track. And I believe this happened because the professors wanted to teach students simpler techniques, and then everyone in the profession marched in lockstep, believing that these techniques were the only way to do things. In reality, many of the current techniques don't have the track record to support them. In short, our mission is only to enlighten you that there is a better way and to make you a better practitioner so that you can provide better service to your patients. We have no financial interest in any company or product, and we have no self-serving agenda. Personally, I feel strongly that the information and experience that was given to me must be passed on to others, or it will go by the wayside, and that would be a terrible tragedy. And this website is an attempt to do just that. It's so upsetting to see so many practitioners striving to hang their hat on something when it comes to crown and bridge work. We see practitioners having difficulties with crowns falling out and recurrent decay under their restorations. Sadly, these problems were actually solved in the 1930s. It's not normal to have crowns falling out and require frequent re-cementation. When crowns come out, they leak and decay. Many practitioners cling to the blind hope that new technology and the latest bonding materials and cements will solve these problems. Wishful thinking. The reality is that they won't, and we will uncover the reasons why. It's important to recognize that technology is not an end in itself. It is only a tool. Corporations care only about selling the technology, and patients and dentists alike are mesmerized by it. Some technology is to be embraced because it adheres to basic principles that are tried and true and improves the practice of dentistry. However, some of the more popular technology does not, and we will show you why. In fact, we want to show you how you can make full coverage restorations you can hang your hat on, and how you can save many teeth that a growing number of practitioners cannot. We want to introduce you to the double tilt precision attachment case, which has perhaps the best track record in dentistry, and most dentists don't know anything about it. This case is successful not only with natural tooth abutments, but with implant abutments as well. We want to give you a new approach to diagnosing and treatment planning that will allow you to incorporate new treatment options into your practice for both patients who are candidates for sophisticated dentistry and also for those who are not. And we will also show you how to manage difficult cases so that you don't lose control of your patients. It's our hope that this website enlightens you about the basic principles that contribute to successful outcomes. Here's an example. Take a look at this case. What are the factors that enable this case to succeed for 35 years? This case has succeeded because of the basic principles of engineering and the way it was designed to minimize the forces on the supporting structures, which is the bone and the roots. You see how the dentistry relates to the bone? This is no accident. This was done this way on purpose, and that's why the changes in the x-rays have been minimal over the last 35 years. It looks like the dentistry is sitting right on the bone, but of course that's not the case. But no one is talking about this, and if you look at x-rays of most people's work, you won't see this. They all look like this, done according to proper basic principles and techniques. I would not be surprised if you could find a single course where they show you a lot of cases with x-rays. And most of the time when you go to the courses, all you get to see are cases done on healthy 25-year-olds where almost anything will work. What about the middle-aged patients who have systemic conditions with heart disease, cancer, and diabetes? How do the techniques work on those patients? That's the true test of how good any technique actually is. I'm going to show you many such cases because these cases were done on patients that already had periodontal bone loss or have cancer and diabetes and heart disease. And many of the cases lasted in spite of these conditions. I want to show you a completely new philosophical approach to full coverage restorative dentistry. Well, it may not be new, but it's new to you. Okay, this philosophy is almost 100 years old, and it began with my dad's teacher, Dr. I. Franklin Miller, who's on the left, in the 1920s. And he was the mentor and teacher to Dr. Elliot Feinberg, who was my father and mentor and teacher. So the approach itself comes from the very roots of the profession, and it certainly has withstood the test of time. And I believe very strongly that if dentistry is going to advance as a profession, any new innovation must be compared to the standard of what came before. Otherwise, how do you advance? This is not being done. Advancements are being promoted only based on their economic advantages and not on science. And I have overwhelming evidence for the techniques that we're going to show you on this website. My dad and I amassed a library of more than 100,000 pictures of crown and bridge precision attachment and implant cases taken during a 70-year period. All of the teeth were prepared and handled in the exact same manner, even though the materials might be different. Many of the cases were followed up for decades with x-rays, and the average case lasts at least 10 years. If this isn't evidence-based dentistry, I don't know what it is. We want you to have the same pleasure of watching your work last in health for many years that we have had. The best feeling in the world is when you get to see these patients come in for their hygiene visits and watch the work that you did last year after year after year, in health. That is the best feeling in the world. We want you to have that feeling. So we want to show you a step-by-step approach. In full coverage dentistry, errors easily introduced into the mix at every turn. Inaccurate impressions and laboratory errors are common. You're heating materials up close to their melting point several times. It is not unusual to have things go wrong. People want to do things in two visits, and skipping steps just compounds the errors and make them difficult to identify. But following a step-by-step approach makes it easy to identify errors and allows their correction before they're compounded with the next step. So at the end, you know you're going to have a perfect result with no guesswork. This actually will save you time. You know, there's a very famous saying that author Jack Bergman penned. There's never enough time to do it right, but there's always enough time to do it over. A step-by-step approach puts you in the driver's seat. You know you're going to have a perfect result at the end, and there's no guesswork. We want to show you how to look at patients with an overall point of view, rather than a piecemeal point of view. And that's what's going on now, a piecemeal point of view, because that's what the insurance companies want to pay for. So economics is taking precedence over health. So the practitioners are being trained to look at the individual trees instead of the whole forest. While this is a reality that we have to deal with, there's no reason why a comprehensive view can't be broken down into individual parts to fit within economic constraints. But first, you have to be trained to look at the patient with an overall point of view, Instead of a piecemeal point of view. And then you could plan it out so at the very end, the patient ends up with a perfect result rather than a hodgepodge. So here's a patient who had a hodgepodge. This patient had dentistry and none of the problems were solved. They cannot be solved with a piecemeal approach, only with an overall approach. So here's another perfect example in a small area. And most people would say, oh, I want to put an implant in this place. It's easy. I'll put something in, make a quick buck, and goodbye and good luck. But does that really the solving the patient's problems? I mean, when you go to lectures of implant lectures, you'll see this all the time. Cases like this where the teeth around the space have been prepared or have big fillings or going to need crowns or leaking and decay, and all they're focusing on is the space with something they could put in and make a quick buck. But it never solves the patient's problem. Whereas if you know how to do good crown and bridge work, you could solve this patient's problem, and that's the end of the recurrent decay and the periodontal bone loss, which is evident in these X-rays. So we want to show you how you can make ideal dentistry in order to solve this problem. And I think much of implant dentistry is the reason it's happening is because people aren't confident with their crown and bridge skills, but they are very adept at placing and restoring implants. But look what I did here with crown and bridge work. You see how the dentistry relates to the bone? That is no accident. That was the end of the recurrent decay. No one could tell that this patient ever had periodontal bone loss. We want to show you how you can do this. We also want to show you new options for restorative treatment. Our approach is very different, and our philosophical approach is different. So because we don't have the same ideas, we can do things that a lot of practitioners cannot. So that's what we want to show you, how you can do that. And we also have some options for those who are not candidates for sophisticated dentistry, as well as options for those who are. So we hope that you will adopt our philosophy and not be so quick to extract teeth. We want to show you how you can restore patients with gradual transitions rather than abrupt changes, which make patients upset and which can cause them to lose confidence in you as a practitioner. Preparing patients for major restorative changes is always the best approach. And as Hippocrates said, first do no harm. So we want you to adopt principle guided practice and not do aimless experimenting. If there's anything I could tell you in my 40 years of practice, it's this. It's so much better to feel like you're on solid ground when you're presenting and performing treatment on a patient. It's so much better to know exactly what to do when something goes wrong along the way. Principle guided practice puts you in the driver's seat, and when you're in control, the patient has confidence that you know what you're doing and that you're going to do right by them. This is what makes dentistry fun and rewarding. So let's go onward and make the practice of dentistry better. We want to help you provide better service to your patients, and we plan to offer courses in easy half-hour long installments that you can look at on a regular basis whenever you want. And they're going to be free. So let your colleagues and friends know that we're here for them too. We look forward to seeing you.